it's really exciting that just right now in the past like 50 or 60 years, we've been able to actually get off of the surface of Earth and start exploring our own universe. I'm Greta Studier, and I'm an engineering major at Swarthmore College. For my senior design project, I have been working with JPL on a future Mars mission. The project that I've been working on is to build a storage unit that will safely hold sample tubes on a Mars rover. This is part of a future mission that JPL is going to do called the Mars Sample Return Mission, which is basically going to send a rover to collect sample tubes, safely store them on a unit, which I have been designing a conceptual design for them for, and then launch those samples back to Earth. We've been sending rovers and satellites to different planets for decades, but the Mars Sample Return Mission will be the first time we have brought back samples from another planet. The parking lot is another name for the storage unit that I've been designing. It's a temporary place for the sample tubes to sit in while the fetch rover's driving around. So these are my two 3D printed test stands for holding sample tubes. These were both printed in the makerspace, and they each have two different mechanisms for retaining sample tubes. This stand all uses clamps. So this is one clamp, and they can retain one sample tube by just inserting it like that. And then this stand uses spring plungers, which basically have a ball on the end and have a spring on the inside, so they are compressible. So when you insert it, it'll stay there. The main mission is to be able to analyze Martian rock for evidence of past life. In a rock core, there could potentially be fossils of bacteria or like really tiny microbes. Instead of relying on the capabilities of a rover on Mars to analyze the content of Martian rock, we could instead bring it back and run more tests in the more robust laboratories on Earth. My mom, when we were little, would bring us outside to say goodnight to the moon. So I've always been interested in space and like the unknown, in parallel with my engineering interests. Knowing what you want to do and then executing it, it's like a big jump sometimes. Coming into Swarthmore, I didn't know what type of engineering I wanted to do, and taking a bunch of different courses at Swarthmore really exposed me to mechanical engineering and design. And so those courses that I took here really got me hooked.